It was a pleasure and a blessing to have known, to have shared in brotherly fellowship, and to have served in frontline leadership ministry with Elder Armbrister. As the district overseer and senior pastor of our work in Matthew Town in Arbor, I found him to be committed, dedicated, diligent, dependable, effective, faithful, visionary, and progressive in ministry. He was a praying man, an able minister of the gospel, who was blessed with good administrative and leadership skills. He made many, many, many personal sacrifices for the advancement of our work in the Nassau. He loved the people of the Nassau. He bonded with them. He was a part of them and of their community. His people loved him. They supported him. And they worked diligently with his vision for the way forward for the district. Elder Armbrister's respectable and influential leadership, along with his sound knowledge and effective impartation of the Word of God, resulted in stability, in growth, and in the strengthening of our work on that island. Although being grave and serious in God's work, Clarence Armbrister had a wonderful sense of humor. Amen. Wow. I'm battling my own spirit right now. But he would make you laugh and laugh and laugh until if you were going through any stress, any distress, it would just dissipate. That's the kind of person he was. He lived in a stress-free zone. At Bishop Ferguson, of the many quotes that really made me laugh, I lifted my spirits because they were different. You know, you don't hear them everywhere, every day, and from everybody. But Benny said something like, as white is on rice, so is ugly on monkey. Those kinds of things. Beyond that, many were in this company, you could be assured to get words of consolation and encouragement to press on. He was deeply spiritual, though humorous. How vividly I can recall him saying as we sat together in a luncheon meeting one day in an hour, Bishop Rahming, the office in which you serve will keep you under constant pressure and stress. Say, these people will stress you out. Say, but Bishop, don't worry about that. Stay focused. Keep your eyes on the prize. God is with you. Stay close to God and everything will be just all right. I thanked him and I blessed him accordingly. Now, Clarence Franklin and Bristol was that kind of a man and minister of Jesus Christ. He lived to touch the lives of others. He served to please his God and to bless others. And he shared to motivate and to empower others. I believe this model was, if I could help someone as I travel along, then my giving shall not be in vain. So, bereaved family, friends, fellow owners, today and in the days ahead, we can all reflect and give thanks to Almighty God for the wonderful life and legacy of a man who lived lovingly, who served faithfully, and who died peacefully, safe in the arms of Jesus, safe on his gentle breast, there by his love overshaded, sweetly his soul shall rest.